Hi, I'm Andy Amrine. I'm your host of Handy Andy here on BPTV, and welcome to another segment on Bethpark TV Cable. And I'm going to introduce you to my co-host today. Our co-hosts today are Japanese Beatles. And the Japanese Beatles, they are in full force right now here in July in the summertime. And then there's a reason that everybody is getting the Japanese Beatles, and that's due to the life cycle of the beetle to grub. So let's talk a little bit about the Japanese beetles, and we're going to show you some of the different products we can use to combat the beetles and combat the grubs. Japanese beetles, this is the time of year for it. And in talking about Japanese beetles have a cycle to their life itself. They're 12 months, but out of the ground as Japanese beetles, you only see them generally from mid-June to the end of July. And then the Japanese beetle itself will go back into the ground, they'll lay its eggs. The baby beetles lay its eggs in the ground. Those ground eggs, when they grow, they turn into the grubs, all those little white grubs that grow into the grass, eat all the grass, eat all the roots. Then their cycle takes them through the yards. Come fall, you're going to get a lot of the grubs who are destroying the yards itself. So if you have Japanese beetles now, rest assured your yard is going to be inundated with the grubs come fall. So, and then after comes spring again, when those join the winter time, the grubs actually go real deep and go dormant. Come spring, the grubs will come back up to the surface, but then they morph into the Japanese beetles coming out of the ground come June again. And it's just a cycle that these beetles slash grubs do year after year after year. So in the summertime, in June, July, there's different ways that we can treat the Japanese beetle, trapping them, killing them, using powders, using sprays, and it'll break the cycle of having beetles and grubs and beetles and grubs. And then if you've missed the cycle of the beetles, then there's ways of killing the grubs itself, putting the insecticides down, putting them down in spring, putting them down in fall. And all we're trying to do is break the cycle of always having the beetles and the grubs itself. But now this time of year, we're in the midst of summer. We're in early July right now here in Bethel Park. And a lot of people are coming in asking what we can do for the Japanese beetles. The most common way that people go after the Japanese beetle is to use the traps itself. And there's a couple different brands of, you know, beetle traps, the Safer, the Spectracide. The brand that I like the best is Rescue. The reason I like the Rescue trap is because of the size of the trap. If you're trapping Japanese beetles, you want a larger trap. The Japanese beetles, there's an attractant that's on the top of the trap itself. That's a sex lure, a pheromone attractant that's attracting the Japanese beetle. They fly in, they hit, they fall down into the trap. Once they're in the bag, they can't get back out. But with some of the other brands, the bags are a lot smaller, and when the bags fill up, you have to throw them out. With this brand itself, there's a little zipper on the bottom. So after the bag is filled, you could sit and dump it into another garbage bag, into your garbage can. And then what you can do is just keep reusing the trap instead of constantly having to buy new bags on it. But traps, what you do with the trap, whether you have a stake, we have different size stakes that you can just sit and hang it in the yard itself, or you can hang it from a tree, you can hang it from a branch, hang it from a fence post, the quarter of the garden. But trapping them is a very, very good way to get rid of the Japanese beetles around your house, around your garden itself. And the idea what a Japanese beetle is doing while it's out, it's only doing two things. It's eating and it's mating. So where they are eating is a lot in your flowers, in your garden. So it's important to be trapping them because you've spent all that time this spring either building a pallet garden or building some other kind of garden, and these Japanese beetles are all over the garden just eating, constantly eating all the leaves itself. So you really want to go and take a trap, hang it somewhere around your garden so itself you can trap them and doing away with them. Another thing you could be doing besides trapping the Japanese beetles itself is you could be killing them. And, you know, with the trap, they dehydrate, they suffocate. That's how the trap works. But we have all the different type of sprays that you can use with it. Your neem spray is a very organic-based type of a sprayer. And some people aren't even familiar with neem being used on Japanese beetles, but it's an excellent one for an all-around insect for products around the house, whether it's edible products or not. The Japanese beetle spray, this is a pyrethrin chemical. It's a straight chemical type spray, and then we have some organic ones that are available. Bonide makes one that's called Captain Jack's Dead Bug Brew. Really interesting name. It's made from the byproducts from your whiskey distillery plants. So think of everything that they take out of the whiskey distillery plants that they're making. They use that product and they found it's a very good bug killer, once again organic. Or 7 and 8, two different brand names. 8 is a little bit more potent than the 7 brand, but what these are is liquids or powder. A lot of people take a powder, whether it's in a little shaker container, or if you have the larger bag for larger areas, what you're doing with the dust is you're just dusting the entire plant itself. And what the dust will do, it'll kill what's on there, and it leaves a nice residual on the plants that new Japanese beetles or any other type of insect that'll come onto the plant will be killed by the dust itself. Where with the liquids, it's not really a long-term type of effect. There's not the residual effect with them. When you're spraying any of the type of liquids, any of the bugs that it comes in contact with, and it's not just the Japanese beetle, but it's any of the other ones, it'll kill them, but it doesn't have a long-term residual effect to it like the powders do. So powders are a little bit messier, but I prefer using the powders over the liquids because you do have that longer term residual effect with them. And what you want to do on the liquids or on the powders itself, you really want to make sure you're coating the entire plant and the surface area. So if you want to start at the top of the plant with any of the liquids or the dust, spray the leaves, spray the top, and work your way all the way down and spraying around the soil area itself. Because a lot of the Japanese beetles that are on the plants are not just on the plants, they're on the soil part. And you want to make sure you're getting them all. So if you're killing them, you're killing all of them. You're not just killing part of them. And then, you know, in a short time, they're going to work their way back up and eat the plants itself. So it's a good way, whether you like the liquids, whether you like the powders, you want to go and protect those garden, protect those plants. They love any of the leafy type of plants. They're not going to go after the pine trees or the evergreens, but they're going to go after everything from your tomato plants. Your rose bushes are probably its prime. I mean, that's their top of the line. That's their lobster and steaks that they're going after. So if you're into having a lot of rose bushes around your house, you definitely want to start protecting yourself. And if you've only seen 2 or 3, you know, that's fine. But if these are rose bushes that you really want to protect, you want to make sure that you're treating them to keep it off of all of those rose bushes. And this is just something you have to do for a couple of months, for June and July. Come August, those Japanese beetles are going to be gone. They're going to be back down in the ground. So protect them for those couple months from either from the Japanese beetles, whether using the sprays, whether you're using the powders on it. But as we've been talking about the traps and the safer brand of traps, you do have the replacement bags, you do have the replacement baits. On some of the other ones with the rescue, everything is there, everything is all in one. Now, what we were talking about with the Japanese beetles, once they're going back into a ground, once they've mated, once they've laid those 100 eggs per Japanese beetles, so that one beetle is now going to turn into 70 to 100 grubs. Then you have to start treating your yard for the grubs itself. So let me show you some of the grub products. Now we're getting into the other cycle of the Japanese beetles, which are the grubs. And I'm sure most people are well aware of the damage that is done to a yard by the grubs itself. You'll go through a yard and you'll see a lot of plush green grass, and all of a sudden you see lots of big brown patches. Most of the time what those brown patches are the grubs are going through and just eating all the roots of the grass itself. When you don't have any roots to the grass, what's going to happen to the grass that's above soil? It's going to be brown. It's going to be dead. And there's no way of reviving that grass You got to dig it up and you got to replant. So to prevent yourself from losing a lot of your yard itself, it's a good idea to be treating for the grubs itself. And grubs, like we stated, grubs are nothing except the Japanese beetles in a different cycle itself. So there's some different products for the grubs itself. A big difference when you're looking at the different type of grub products is whether it's a 24-hour kill type of product or it's a long-term type of product itself. A lot of people are familiar with GrubX. GrubX made by Scotts is a very good product, but it doesn't fast kill the grubs itself. It's more of a, you put it on in spring, it takes about a month to ramp itself up, and then it prevents the grubs from thriving throughout the rest of the year. But if you have Japanese beetles and now all of a sudden you're getting into the August, September, the fall cycle, and you see you're getting some grub damage, a product like GrubX isn't going to help you because it's going to take too long to kill the grubs. By the time you've killed them, they've already destroyed your yard. That's why you want to go after a product like Bear or Jonathan Green. These have a chemical in that I call a 24-hour kill. You put these products on the yard itself, and within 24 hours, the chemical is reacted into the soil, and it's killed the grubs that you've had. So one's more of a long-term slow effect, but these are an instant type of kill where when you're having grub problems itself, you want to take care of those grubs before they destroy the yard itself. So think of the Bear, think of the Jonathan Green. This time of year, those are the better grub control products, rather than the spring type product, which is what I consider the GrubX. So the cycle of the Japanese beetles, going from June and July where they're outside eating up all your plants, to August, September, October, when they've turned to grubs and they're in the soil, destroying your grass itself. All right, Japanese beetles, grubs, it's amazing how these two are so intertwined. So remember, if you have Japanese beetles, you're going to have grubs, or if you have grubs, you're going to have Japanese beetles. So it's the life cycle of these beetles to grubs. The beetles are out in June, July. You know, come August, they're back into the ground. They've laid the eggs the end of July. Then in August, they're growing these eggs. And then come fall, they're back into the grubs. The grubs are chewing up your yard through the fall. They lay dormant in the winter. They come back as grubs in the spring when it starts warming up a little bit, and then back into those Japanese beetles again. So you gotta break the cycle. So whether you're trying to combat them while they're Japanese beetles, or you're trying to combat them when they're grubs, or you're doing both. I've seen areas all around Pittsburgh already that have tens of thousands of Japanese beetles. We know that it's gonna be a vicious cycle. We know that it's gonna be the beetles destroying their plants, and then it's gonna be the grubs destroying their yard. So do a two-prong type of attack on it. Get the dust, get the sprays, get the traps to go after the beetles, and then treat the yards itself to go after the grubs. So gotta do something to break the cycle out there, or they're gonna be eating everything in sight. But I appreciate you watching another segment of Handy Andy on BPTV. I hope you enjoyed my little friends here, these little Japanese beetles, because they do have a lot of fun this time of year with all your plants. So thank you again for watching, and we'll catch you again soon.